What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Exalted Astrology again. And today, I am so happy because Lord Krishna is going to start. Let's start. Oh my God. Shri Bhagavan Vacha. Oh no. We'll start. And before we begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you don't have to see. You'll hear Him now. Okay. And if you are new to the channel and you have not yet subscribed to it, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a personal consultation, then approach me in my website below. And if you want me to make any other video, then please let me know in the comments. Or if you have any questions, queries, or anything you have not understood from the Gita, or you want me to speak on any particular topic on anything, then please let me know in the comments. Alright, and let's start with the prayers to our preceptors. Om Agyan Timirandhasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Nama. Alright, so till now what did we see? We saw that Arjuna has undergone a complete breakdown. And yeah, if you have not watched the earlier videos, then please watch it, okay? Otherwise, you may feel, oh, what's this person talking here? Okay, and now Arjuna said to Lord Krishna that, Oh Madhusudana, please help me, yes? And then Sanjay said, Lord Krishna is going to speak now. And here you go, the first verse where Lord Krishna speaks in the Gita, and it starts. Yes, finally. So here we go, chapter 2, text number 2. Let's start. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha means, Bhagavan means Lord Krishna is speaking. He's referred to as Bhagavan here. God Himself. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Kutastva Kashmalam Idam Vishame Samupasthitam Anarya Jushtam Aswargyam Akirti Karam Arjunaha. This is one of the famous 108 slokas, okay? So I have this memorized. Alright, so now the Supreme Personality of Godhead said, ears pointed. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, My dear Arjuna, how have these impurities come upon you? They are not at all befitting a man who knows the value of life. They lead not to higher planets but to infamy. I will repeat the purport again. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, My dear Arjuna, how have these impurities come upon you? Kutastva kasmanavidam. They are not at all befitting a man who knows the value of life. Vishame samupasthitam. They lead not to higher planets but to infamy. So basically, Krishna is telling Arjuna, come on man, what are you speaking? He was basically lamenting, oh, I have to kill all my family members, etc. Yes. So now comes the purport to this verse, okay? So, alert. Krishna and the Supreme Personality of Godhead are identical. Should I repeat? Krishna and the Supreme Personality of Godhead are identical. Therefore, Lord Krishna is referred to as Bhagavan throughout the Gita. Point to be noted. Lord Krishna is referred to as Bhagavan throughout the Gita. That means wherever Lord Krishna speaks, you will always see this verse. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. The moment you see Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, you understand Lord Krishna is speaking. Bhagavan is the ultimate in the absolute truth. The absolute truth is realized in three phases of understanding. Brahman, impersonal all-pervasive spirit, Paramatma, or the localized aspect of the Supreme within the heart of all living beings. That's the second. And the third is Bhagavan. I will repeat. First is the impersonal all-pervasive Brahman which is there. Then second is the localized Paramatma aspect, which is actually known as Paramatma. It's the localized version of God which we have. And then third is the personal aspect of God, which is Bhagavan. Okay. So the absolute truth is realized in three phases of understanding, namely Brahman, the impersonal all-pervasive spirit. Now what does this mean? This means that the spirit, which is pure consciousness, it realizes God in three levels. Okay, the first level here is Brahman realization. Brahman means, this is not the Brahminical structure which is there in India, that is different, that is Brahmana. Okay, that is different. Don't confuse this Brahman with Brahmana. Brahmana is different. Brahmana is one who knows Brahma. All right, Brahma means spirit. So Brahma means spirit. So it is realized in three phases. So the first phase is Brahman, that is the impersonal all pervasive spirit. Now this material world is composed of 14 planetary systems. So when you go beyond these 14 planetary systems, there is something called as Brahma Jyoti, all pervasive light spirit, where you see the illumination from the body of God. Yes, that is known as Brahman. That is the impersonal understanding of God. That means if you are liberated from this material world, which means you have no desire to enjoy materialistic objects, then you may go to Brahma Jyoti. Jyoti refers to light. Brahma means God. So the light which emanates from the body of the Supreme Lord, yes, from Lord Vishnu, that light is known as Brahman, and that is known as Brahman effulgence. That is the all pervasive impersonal aspect. Impersonal means there is no person there. It's just simply light. All right, there's no person there. You don't see a man there. That is why it is called impersonal. Then is the Paramatma, or the localized aspect of the Supreme within the heart of all living beings. Paramatma refers to that 400 form of Lord Vishnu who is situated in every living being's heart. So this means that when a person reaches Brahman realization, all right, after that you realize that God is inside your heart. All right, and this is not something which people say, oh, God is there in everybody's heart. No, it's not like that. It is in this 400 form which is mentioned here, Paramatma. All right, Paramatma, Param means supreme, Atma means soul. So he is the supreme soul. So the next level is the Paramatma realization. That means you not only go beyond this material world, you also realize that God has a 400 form where he is standing in our heart. All right, but that is a localized aspect of the Supreme within the hearts of all living entities. Then the third is Bhagavan, or the Supreme Personality of Godhead. See, the personality aspect is stressed here. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st canto, 2nd chapter, 11th verse, the conception of the Absolute Truth is explained here. Vadanti tat tattva vidas tattvam yad dhyanam abhyayam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavan iti shabdyate. Again, three things are mentioned. The Absolute Truth is realized in the three phases of understanding by the knower of the Absolute Truth. Absolute Truth refers to God. So God can be known at three levels. And then all of them are identical, which means all three are the same. Such phases of the Absolute Truth are expressed as Brahman, which is the all-pervasive light, and then Paramatma, the localized version of God which is there inside your heart, and then is Bhagavan. Bhagavan is referring to the complete personality of God, all right, where we see God as a person, where which is in the spiritual world, where God stays and we interact with God on a personal level, like you interact with your husband or with your wife, with your mother, your father. Yes, the personality of God is experienced in the level of Bhagavan. All right, in the other two, in Brahman realization, there is no realization of personality. It's just light. It's void, nirakar. But in case of Paramatma, you realize that God is there. You see the 400 form, but there is not much reciprocation in that. Okay, but in case of Bhagavan, there is complete reciprocation, complete 100% reciprocation. There, these three divine aspects can be explained by the example of sun, which also has three different aspects. So now example is given, namely the sunshine, the sun's surface, and the sun planet itself. So that means these three aspects can be compared to like the planet sun. So now sun has sun rays, right? That is like Brahman. Then the surface of the sun, it is like Paramatma. And then the sun planet itself is like Bhagavan. Very good example, right? One who studies the sunshine only is the preliminary student. So many people think that God is light, God is nirakar, he is formless. So that means that person is in the preliminary stage of God realization. That's what is mentioned here. One who studies the sunshine only is the preliminary student. That means you have to understand that there is a personal form of God beyond that sunshine. Sunshine, I mean, in this case, for the planet Sun. And one who can enter into the sun planet is the highest. Ordinary students who are satisfied by simply understanding the sunshine, its universal pervasiveness and the glaring effulgence of its impersonal nature may be compared to those who can realize only the Brahman feature of the absolute truth. This means those who think that God is not a person, he is just simply a bunch of light. That means that person is in the preliminary stages of spiritual realization. The student who has advanced still further can know the sun disk, which is compared to the knowledge of the Paramatma feature of the Absolute. Alright. As I already said, that the disk of the sun, which is visible from outside, that is like the feature of the Paramatma. But there is not much reciprocation in that. And the student who can enter into the heart of the sun planet is compared to those who realize the personal features of the Absolute Truth. Now you see. Therefore, the bhaktas or the transcendentalists who have realized the Bhagavan feature of the Absolute Truth are the topmost transcendentalists. Although all students who are engaged in the study of the Absolute Truth are engaged in the same subject matter. So it's like three students are there who are studying the same thing, but one who has understood the concept of Bhagavan, that means the personal form of God, he is at the highest stage. The sunshine, the sun disk, and the inner affairs of the sun planet cannot be separated from one another, and yet the students of the three different phases are not in the same category. Alright. The Sanskrit word Bhagavan is explained by the great authority Parashar Muni, the father of Vyasdev. Parashara is also the author of the BPHS, Brihat Parashara Hora Shastra, Astrology. Yes, it has come from Parashara. The Supreme Personality, who possesses all richness, strength, fame, beauty, knowledge, and renunciation. Six characteristics. What are the six characteristics? Let's talk again. Yes. The Supreme Personality, who possesses all riches, all strength, all fame, all beauty, all knowledge, and all renunciation, is called Bhagavan. Like in Hindi, we say na, Balwan. Balavan means one who has a lot of strength. So Bhagavan means one who has Bhaga. And Bhaga refers to these six traits. What are the six traits? Once again, strength, fame, beauty, knowledge, renunciation, and riches. There are many persons who are very rich, very powerful, very beautiful, very famous, very learned, and very much detached. But no one can claim that he possesses all riches, all strength, etc. That means there can be a scientist who has a lot of knowledge, but he may not be the most beautiful person. There can be a lady who looks like a Miss Universe, but she may not be a scientist, right? There may be a bodybuilder, but he may not have any knowledge. So you may have power over certain things in this world, but you cannot have power on everything. That's what is told here. Entirety. Only Krishna can claim this because he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That means only Lord Krishna is the one who can say that I have all these six opulences in full, more than anybody else in this world. Alright. No living entity, including Brahma, Shiva, or Narayana, can possess opulences as fully as Krishna. Therefore, it is concluded in the Brahma Samhita by Lord Brahma himself that Lord Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. No one is equal to or above him. He is the primeval Lord or Bhagavan, known as Govinda, and he is the supreme cause of all causes. And this is the shloka from Brahma Samhita, which states this. Okay, Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachid Ananda Vigraha Anadiradir Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam. There are many personalities possessing the qualities of Bhagavan, but Krishna is the supreme because no one can excel him. He is the supreme person. His body is eternal, full of knowledge and bliss. Sat, Chit, Ananda, full of eternity, full of knowledge and full of bliss. He is the primeval Lord Govinda and the cause of all causes. Brahma Samhita, 5th chapter, 1st verse. In the Bhagavatam, there is a list of many incarnations of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but Krishna is described as the original personality of Godhead, from whom many incarnations and personalities of Godhead expand. Hear this shloka very carefully. This is one of my favorite shlokas from the Bhagavatam. Ete cha amsa kala pumsam Krishna astu bhagavana swayam Indrari vaikulyam lokam mridyanti yuge yuge. All the lists of the incarnations of Godhead submitted herewith are either plenary expansions or parts of the plenary expansions of the Supreme Godhead. But Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Srimad Bhagavatam 1.3.28, 1st Canto, 3rd Chapter, 28th Verse. But Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead Himself. Therefore, Krishna is the original Supreme Personality of Godhead, the Absolute Truth, the source of both the Super Soul and the Impersonal Brahman. Alright? So, Lord Krishna is the source of the first two levels of spiritual realization. In the presence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Arjuna's lamentation for his kinsmen is certainly unbecoming. And therefore, Krishna expressed his surprise with the word kuta. Yes. Kutastva kasmalamidam. It means where from? He is telling where from these impurities have come upon you, Arjuna. Such impurities were never expected from a person belonging to the civilized class of men known as Aryans. The word Aryan is applicable to persons who know the value of life and have a civilization based on spiritual realization. Persons who are led by the materialistic conception of life do not know that the aim of life is realization of the Absolute Truth, Vishnu or Bhagavan. And they are captivated by the external features of the material world. My husband, my wife, my children. And therefore, they do not know what liberation is. Persons who have no knowledge of liberation from material bondage are called non-Aryans. Although Arjuna was a Kshatriya, he was deviating from the prescribed duties by declining to fight. This act of cowardice is described as befitting the non-Aryans. Such deviation from duty does not help one in the progress of spiritual life, nor does it even give one the opportunity to become famous in this world. That's why Lord Krishna said this will cause you infamy. Lord Krishna did not approve of the so-called compassion of Arjuna for his kinsmen. So here basically, what are the things that have been stressed? First of all, Lord Krishna's supremacy has been established here, alright? And then it has been said here that there are three levels of realization of God, about which we will discuss more. The Gita is all about them. So first level is the impersonal aspect of God, the light which is known as Brahma Jyoti, which emanates from the body of Lord Krishna, alright? That is the preliminary realization. And then you have the Paramatma feature, the four-handed form of Lord Vishnu, who is standing in everybody's heart, near the location of the heart. And then we have Bhagavan, which is the person itself, okay? And then Parashara says, there are six traits of the six traits of Bhagavan, yes? What are they? Rich, strength, fame, beauty, knowledge, and renunciation. These are the six traits. So only Lord Krishna is the one who possesses all this, not even Lord Vishnu. Because there are certain things which Vishnu also does not have, but Lord Krishna has. That is, Leela Madhurya, he has a lot of intimate pastimes with his devotees in Vrindavan. And then there is Venu Madhurya, he has this peacock feather in his head. And then he has the flute also, yes. Leela Madhurya, Venur Madhurya and he is exquisitely beautiful. So there are 64 qualities of Krishna, out of which Vishnu possesses only 60, about which we will discuss more in detail, of course. So that's what is the meaning of the word Bhagavan. And then Lord Krishna's supremacy is being stressed here by saying that he is the ultimate cause. He is Sat Chit Ananda, full of, he's eternal, full of knowledge and full of bliss. Bliss means happiness. And then it is said here that There are so many incarnations. Etech cha amsa kala pumsam. Amsas and kalas, about which we will discuss in future. But Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. But Lord Krishna is the supreme. He is the origin of all the avatars of Vishnu. And then at the end it is said here that Lord Krishna does not approve of this so-called compassion of Arjuna for his kingsmen, because they were not deserving to live, because they had done so many atrocities, they had done so many crimes against the Pandavas. Yes, so they deserve to be punished and to be killed also. So Lord Krishna is telling that anybody who is not having the spiritual quotient inside them, that person is a non-Aryan, and one who knows the value of life and are belonging to the civilized class are known as Aryans. Okay, so we will discuss on the things later, and I will end this video here. So there you go, Lord Krishna starts speaking, quite a heavy verse. Yes, suddenly the bomb is dispelled here. All right, if you are new to the channel and you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it, and if you want a consultation, then please approach me in my website. And if you have any questions, queries or comments on this video, which you might have, but please wait till I answer them, alright? And they will be cleared further in the upcoming videos, okay? Until next time, wish you good luck. Bye-bye. See you.